Ah, you're awake! Oi, you ain't undead, are you? Can you move? Can you move? Ah, you're awake! Oi, you ain't undead, are you? Can you talk? Speak to me!
If what the halfling said was true, no one but you made it to the island alive.
Come on!
It may be worth following this rogue. For now.
This follow me. Here we are. So you want a weapon or not? Give it a few swings.
As you take hold of the weapon, feeling its balance, you can't help but notice this Jeets has more he wants to say.
Salimus is at the grotto. Tell her to keep her knickers on.
Salimus is in the grotto. I shall show you the way. This is all from dragon-wrecked ships.
Is this Salimus, the cleric you were sent to find?
Who in Kyber are you? First, I shall surround us with a protection spell.
Her spell temporarily prevents you from dying, though you can still suffer injuries. This effect will wear off when you leave these caves.
Now, let's be about it. A gate? There must be a way to open it. Try up that ladder. I'll remain here and bash any Sawagin trying to sneak out.
You hear the shuffling and wheezing of some creature coming from the corridor ahead.
Hey.
no time to die.
The corroded lever at the rear of this corridor most likely controls the gate where the cleric, Salimus is waiting.
Salimus isn't too honked at me. Thanks for putting in the good word. Don't you worry, Salimus. I'm here to watch your behind now.
The evil aura is oppressive. Sawagin are behind this door.
Charge!
What, it's empty?
Oi, where's the bloody Sawagin?
Look, the door closed behind us.
It would be logical to assume...
Trap!
More of them up there. Stay alert.
For the flame!
Sawagin wretches, are you scared of me? Come down and fight! Just smite you! Such is the fate of evil. Now, let's find a way out of here.
Can't pick this. Anyone see a key?
Curious. I just stepped on something. A latch.
Good work! I see a key down there. Who's up for a swim?
Hydrophobia mean anything to you?
You grab the silver key. Time to swim for the surface.
I knew you'd come in, Andy. For the flame's sake, someone go down there. I'm weary. Let's take a moment to rest.
Ha! I still got plenty of stamina. I can go all night long.
Why don't you scout ahead then? Just don't get yourself in trouble.
Now you're talking. I'll take a little peek.
If you're done resting, go and scout ahead with Jeets.
Crikey! Ha! It was no match for yours truly. You can open the door now.
You two having fun? It's time for us to go. The High Priestess should be up ahead. The onus for much suffering rests squarely upon her slimy, webbed hands. There she is. performing some kind of profane blood magic.
I will open the door. Prepare yourself. Ready? Go!
According to our employer, there's a secret passage around here somewhere leading to Korthos. You boys look for it. I must cleanse the profane energies around the shrine.
Let Salimis do her thing. You and I'll take care of the important stuff. The treasure. Senses are tingling. There's something fishy in this
you
room.
You feel a stiff draft from somewhere in this room. Perhaps the hidden passage to the village is in here.
Found the secret passage? Go on, open it then. Brilliant! Tidy lasses and pints up the wazoo! Here I come!
We're almost done here. The way out is up ahead. But first, I want to reward you for your assistance. Please, come speak with me.
Stepping out of the grotto, you find yourself in Korthos village. The Sahuagin have threatened this place for generations. Judging from how it looks now, the Sahuagin are winning. However, some hopeful souls still hold out for help to arrive. Coming from deep in the crypt, you hear the strange and unsettling echoes that Kaya spoke of. And by the passage leading in, strange. Sarcophagi line the walls, but they're broken open and empty. Where did the bodies go? What were those cultists up to? This bears more investigation. A treasure chest glimmers in the dark passage here. Though rusty, this longsword is still sharp. It's a slashing weapon, perfect for slicing through putrid zombie flesh that would resist puncturing or bludgeoning weapons. As you slay these foul cultists, take care to keep your own health up. Another treasure chest. Perhaps this heavy mace is a bludgeoning weapon, ideal for smashing apart skeletons. Their bones are resistant to puncturing or slashing weapons. Thank you. In the middle of this chamber is an evil devourer altar. By it, a Sahuagin rumbles. For the Sahuagin's a magical crest appears from the destroyed altar. If you take it with you, it may be useful later. You continue to hear cultists about their evil work from further inside the crypt. A chest. It's out in the open. Acid sprays out of the wall as the gate slams shut. This is a dark and dusty passage. It doesn't look like anyone's come through here in decades. There's a Sahuagin in here, performing some kind of ritual.
Come, dead son of Korthos. Rise and do my bidding.
The Sahuagin were using this another crest drops out as you smash the altar. There might still be other altars elsewhere in this crypt. There's another Sahuagin. It croaks.
Cragwolf Hayton, in life you served the light.
When the altar collapses, a third crest appears. It glows with cold magic. A magical barrier blocks the way, and behind it,
you fit the last crest in place,
and the magic shield dissipates. The Sahuagin inside spits out in a venomous voice.
These fools who would keep Korthos shall be consumed by the Devourer.
The
looking down at a corpse on the altar. The Sahuagin says,
"And you, dead hero of hate and blood, shall be the devourer's teeth."
Your bold actions saved Korthos and brought the Sahuagin's fell scheme to naught. The treasure chest in the antechamber is now yours. Some of the braver villagers tried to stem the Sahuagin tide, but their courage led to naught but grievous injuries. Korthos needs someone with more than just guts.
Dust and mold fill this ill-maintained storehouse. You can hear the telltale skittering of vermin nearby. This appears to be the main. A Sahuagin emerges from a hidden passage, demanding the key. You must let the scrolls fall into our hands. The door swings open, revealing a magical sphere around the scroll. It appears that the floor in this room can be moved and rotated.
Hmm.
The protective spell dissipates. All that remains now is to take and deliver the scroll. Ahead is the cellar where the Caenith crystal is hidden. You can feel the life-saving heat emanating from the magic crystal Baldar spoke of. But from the shadows approach those who would doom Korthos by destroying it. With a well-aimed blow, Korthos is doomed to an icy grave. Ahead is the cellar where the Caenith crystal is hidden. You can feel the life-saving heat emanating from the magic crystal Baldar spoke of. But from the shadows approach those who would doom Korthos by destroying it. Yeah. last cultist, thus protecting the Kaneth Crystal and saving Korthos. Your waiting bears fruit. This must be the collaborator stepping in from the dark. Your stalwart defense gives the Sahagin pause, but you hear more of them gathering outside for a final assault. You notice a small chest hidden behind the bar. Now, after that traitorous Jacoby Drexel hand, he must have fled into the cellar. Drexel hand isn't here. However, webbed footprints on the ground betray the location of a secret passage. Backtracking them may reveal that the chamber beyond the secret passage looks ancient, predating Korthos village.
Oh.
there. That weaselly Drexel hand has nowhere left to run. Finish the job. Drexel thought that siding with the Sahuagin would save his life.
Your victories have made the village much safer, but only temporarily. It's time to take the fight to the Sahuagin, out in the wilds of Korthos Island.
steam billows from the hidden entrance of an underground Korthos. The air grows damp and fetid as the ancient tunnel descends. The tunnel splits here. Which way to the giantish device? The sound of distant snoring warns you that you are not alone here. If you're careful, you may be able to take the sleeping guards by surprise. The extravagant gong in this room looks capable of truly ear-shattering noise. With the gong's reverberations, you hear a slight rumble from the larger room, but then it stops. second strike of the gong produces the telltale sound of cracks. You spot a rusty hatch submerged in the putrid water. Emerge from the murky water with great relief. The air seems slightly cooler here. The temperature plunges as you forge ahead. The giantish device must fall. Ahead is the giant device. The freezing mists it is spewing are directed the wrong way. With the right timing, you can get close enough to redirect them. The mist solidifies into ice over the ancient creature, but it's not enough. You need both jets to affect a thing of this size. A layer of ice forms over the ancient creature, guaranteeing its slumber. Korthos is safe for now. Steam billows from the hidden entrance to an underground complex.
Yeah.
A mangled sewer grate leads to an old abandoned Caneth manufactory. You enter one of the laboratories where decades ago House Caneth first imbued mystical life into automatons. Much later, the doorway ahead has been boarded up. Oddly, the work looks very recent. A magical barrier, humming with compressed energy, resolutely blocks your path. You hope you can find a way to disable it somehow. Icy jets of some alchemical compound coat these humming Caneth power crystals in a hard protected layer. You also notice several valves of various sizes spread around the room. Upon turning the valve, you hear a definite alteration in the pitch of the hiss as the gas struggles to flow around your obstruction. Without the alchemical jets coating the Caneth power crystals, you can now easily destroy them. As the last crystal shatters, the hum of power slowly fades into a heavy silence.
in the flame are you? Oh no, the Sawagin found me.
Suddenly the air shimmers with devourer magic. The Sahagin have followed you in and are attacking. He flies right in your hands now.
They wouldn't have sent so few after me. Stay alert. It'll take more than that to put me down, Sahagin. The Sahagin are still blocking our escape. Watch for more attacks. Keep coming! I won't die that easily. Sahagin get you upset, they won't stop until you're dead. We might actually get through this. Just hold for a little longer. The Sahagin magic is gone. We beat them off. This time.
Hayden looks weary after surviving this latest attack. Perhaps you should talk to him again.
Go now. Tell Ursa to hold the barricade just a little longer. Then meet Amalgam at the base of Misery's Peak when you're ready.
With Hayton finally persuaded to help, the people of Korthos might finally win their struggle. A mangled sewer grate leads to an old abandoned Caneth manufactory.
Your finding Hayton transformed the village. It seems as if all of Korthos were holding out for news of your next great victory with bated breath.
You come across a makeshift camp. A scraggly dwarf sits on a log, trying in vain to keep warm. A bone-chilling breeze emanates from the mouth of Misery's Peak.
You're here. Come, there isn't much time. Selimus, ready your party. I'll weaken the barrier for you.
Ready! Charge!
Good. Now to clear your path.
Hayden clears the passageway for you. Now to find this quarry Mindsunder artifact.
Go, quickly. I will mask your presence.
Victims of the Devourer cult arise from the icy land, bound to slay the living and add to their grim number.
Thank you.
Several humanoid figures surround a glowing pedestal. Their putrid forms are frozen in contorted poses, their faces set in silent, eternal screams. The second signal crystal activated. You hear the stone door at the base of the cavern rolling open. Chills run down your spine as you finally come face to face with the dragon that has been terrorizing Korthos. Even at rest, it is a truly awesome beast. The door at the rear of the cavern pops open. Cultists, attracted by the roar of combat, rush out to confront you. another heavy door. Hopefully the switch is nearby and not too well guarded. The ground quavers, and you look down to see a tunnel beneath the ice. The dragon roars as it thunders after Selimas and Jeets and Taldron. The ruse is working. Another heavy door bars the way out. Once again, signal crystals are set into the wall. Crystal glows with power as you engage the first control lever, but where is the second? Fresh frozen air gusts in from the newly opened door below. Waves of psychic energy pound into you as you spot a green crystal on the ledge ahead. At last, this must be the quarry Mind Sunder. The Mind Flayer and Dragon are locked in a contest of wills. This could be your chance to destroy the Mind Sunder. The Mind Flayer shrieks as it loses the Mind Sunder's power. The dragon reasserts its will and looks very annoyed.
Follow me. Peyton wants a word with you.
Here, take this portal, so you won't have to walk back.
And like magic, the snows stopped. Savior of Korthos! They cheer as you return. But destiny has greater plans for you than just this small village.
Is the season of festival in Stormreach.